In this video, I will show you how to create a cool, live fire for a biofireplace and help you solve the problem of fast playback of video textures during rendering in the Unreal Engine sequencer. For my fire, I found a suitable source in 4K, 24 frames per second. There are no sparks or smoke in it, and it's not as big and fast as a flame of bonfire. It needs to be looped so that it plays without obvious delays or jumps when a new loop cycle starts, and it needs to be tinted according to the reference. Open DaVinci Resolve for this purpose. Drag the source into the media pool. Agree that the timeline will adjust to the source red frame. Put it on the timeline. The optimal length for a looped clip is 10 seconds. Press on the keyboard numpad 10.0, playhead jumps for 10 seconds. Press M and place a marker on the timeline. If a clip is selected, a marker is placed on it. Press Ctrl plus B to cut the clip under the playhead. Let's make some more fragments to place them in the line of fire. In my case, it took 3 different sections from the original flame footage, so that the flames don't look the same. Let's put a marker on the clip somewhere in the middle. Hold Alt and copy a clip with dragging. Select the clip, Ctrl plus B, crop the clip on both sides so that the markers are at the beginning and the end of the clip. Backspace removes unnecessary. We looped the clip this way. It remains to find a suitable place of a joint between 2 clips. Cut them at the same time with the double side arrow and seek for a similar shape of fire on the left and on the right side of the screen. That should be good. Apply cross dissolve transition. Let's lengthen it a bit. Let's check it. In order to play one fragment several times, we move the cursor to the beginning of the playback and press Alt plus L. Keep holding Alt, press L one more time and one more time. Pretty good. Select it and with Alt held down, drag the whole structure to the right. Imitate the work of the loop tick in Unreal. Let's check it. Done. Delete the unnecessary. Backspace deletes without affecting the rest of the tracks. Delete moves all unblocked tracks at the length of the deleted clip. All we need to do is to prepare more of such clips with different beginning and the end of playback. Prepared clips need to be painted. Go to the Color Correction tab. Alt plus S at the next node, which will be located after the selected one. When you press Shift plus S, the node will be added before the selected one. Add some blue to the bottom of the flame. Draw a mask randomly. Let's move the gamma point into the blue area. Add the outer and inner borders. Let's soften them up. Alt plus S at the new node. Let's color the middle part. As you can see in the reference, this part of the flame is almost white. Decrease the saturation. Increase the gain a little bit. That's so good. Alt plus S, and we have one more node. Let's get some yellowness of the upper flames. Draw a chaotic mask and reduce the saturation a bit. And add the last node that completely removes the flying out flames. After all, we have a quiet burning of a biofireplace, not a bonfire. Do it the standard way. Alt plus S, mask, soft edges and gain to 0. apply color settings and masks to the remaining clips. Select raw clips by using Shift, right-click on the colored clip and click Apply Grade. Now let's solve the problem of accelerated fire playback on the render in the Unreal Engine sequencer. The heart of the problem is that during rendering, the fire is always played in real time, and the render itself on my 26th Super Video card goes at speed of about 8 frames per second. As a result, we get a several times accelerated video on the fire on the texture. Let's fix the situation. Turn on the frame interpolation process in the DaVinci settings, optical flow and enhanced better mode. With these options, DaVinci finishes the painting in missing frames using its built-in algorithm. This allows you to slow down the source at a frame rate of 24 frames per second, 5 times with no visible jumps. Select the clip, press Ctrl plus R and stretch it 5 times, focusing on the percentages indicated on the clip. And then, according to the scheme as described above, we look for a mark on the clip, copy, crop, and look for a suitable joint. Since the clip has already been colored, all that remains is to render the result and assemble the blueprint as in the lectures. The only difference is that instead of one node, you need to add the required amount to assemble a line of fire of the required length. Video files with normal playback speed should be used for interactive walkthrough the scene, since in this case the image processing speed and the video texture playback speed will match. Good luck, everyone!